Hello everyone, and welcome back to the final of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Re-Chain of Memories Part 22. And I hope this is the final. If not, well, I'm just going to look a little bit foolish. Anyway, let's go up there and start this by finishing it with a cutscene.
He said this card will draw Ansem out.
Don't worry. We can defeat him together.
Sorry. I've got to face him alone.
But why?
There's no point in doing this if I can't do it on my own. But I do need a favor. If Ansem is the victor, he is going to enslave me. If that happens, use your powers to destroy...
Of course! I'll be right there to save you.
Huh? No, that's not it. I want you to destroy...
No way! No matter what happens, I'm gonna be right there to help you. I promise you that. Unless you don't believe I'll come through for you.
I choose to believe in you. Always, Your Majesty.
And I in you. You're not gonna lose. I know it.
Thanks.
Storyteller Riku. That means we're done with the story for the D report. All we gotta do is just get the characters, which is the Heartless. Nominates who that is. And we got this. And then we get these three losers. Just kidding. Only these two are the losers. Axel's the cool one, because he's the only one that survived that Castle Oblivion. Gosh damn, get out of the characters. Riku's Tale 6. Alright. Let's talk to Mickey. What did he gotta say? You'd never let the darkness get the best of you. I'm sure of that. Thanks, Mickey. Anyway, let's go into the final world and find the final Heartless. And then we'll probably get like 2 trophies as soon as we beat the... That Heartless, which is the Neo Shadow. Here we go. Castle Oblivion. After this loading screen. Oh, cutscene. I gotta be quiet.
Ansem! Where are you? Show yourself!
Why in such a hurry? I'll be here at the very heart of darkness, watching you plunge into the same darkness inside of you.
Key to beginnings, which is also the key to the end, because it's only one room. And actually, this part probably won't be so long because, well, I'll show you in a bit. As soon as this pops up. Castle Oblivion. And yes, this is pretty short because it's only these 3 rooms and then that. So yeah, this is probably going to be pretty short if we can beat Ansem, that is. But first, let's beat a couple of Heartless and beat that Neo Shadow. So we can get a trophy. And now we have... Okay, it's probably not the best deck because... That's not what I wanted. Because the Neo Shadows... can easily break us because they have a high card of an 8. Like they do against Sora, but... hopefully... we can do some damage. Get back here. I believe we get Barrage... when we have to duel the Neo Shadows, so that's cool. If I can just... screw it, I'm gonna just do... There we go! Character Professor Riku. Don't know why... Oh, maybe I had to defeat the Neo Shadow first. And Record Keeper Riku, that means we got everything in the journal. Or the D report, as is for Riku. Kind of weird that popped up in the middle of the fight. You'd think that'd pop up after. Gosh dang it. Another inverse burst. Yes! This is probably the best place to grind for Riku to level ups. I mean, speaking of level ups, we just got a level. Mainly because, well, it's the place where all the, where the most enemy, not the most, strongest enemies are, so it's like, yeah, it makes sense. Besides, Neo Shouts gives a lot of that. Gosh damn, why can't I ever duel these guys? Okay, see, yeah, they give us, well, almost 300 EXP. Yay, finally. Alright. Attack boost, Adoy. Sorry about that. I could make a save area in here, but I'm not gonna do that, mainly because why? There's only three areas. So I wanna make a I wanna make a room that has somewhat heartless. Yeah, I'll do make this one. Sorry if you hear that noise. It's a slushy. I ate at Taco Bell earlier today, and I got a slushy, and I tried to win a PlayStation 4 because that's going on. Didn't win though, which sucks. Oh well. Why not? Just because there's a lot of heartless in here. Wow, my the levels for my thing are actually kind of weird. When I was going, I don't know, I was doing something and my levels were acting weird to it, and I don't know why I didn't hit anything. Gosh dang it! I really hate. Well, Riku's deck in here isn't that bad. It's like his best, because look at that, we have like three nines in a row. Oh, and we even have a high potion. Finally! Oh, we get Maelstrom. Well, now I know for sure we've seen the dark forms of all of our slates. And look how close we are to another level already. Yeah. Come on. Just go down, dark balls. And then we get one more dark ball. Yeah, and we got another looming darkness card. Wow, our EXP is pretty high. I should get some health. Nothing. Can I get something over here without? Okay, can I get a health? Is it enough? Yeah, close enough. We'll be fine. After we go through this door, we need 13. Ooh, but you know, I think we're just going to use our last random Joker card, and then our key to beginnings. This might actually be a pretty short part, but then again, it has the credits and everything, so yeah. And now I do apologize in advance that I have to cut out the credits. It's all the copyrights. Well, I don't cut out the credits, I cut out the music. It's all in copyright, so I apologize for that. But stay to watch the credits, because there's some scenes, like I think three scenes like it was in the in Sora's credits, that you get to see. That's kind of pretty cool. Anyway, here we go. Let's do this. The beginning of the end for Riku's story. Actually, it's pretty much the end if we beat Ansem. But it is, of course, a cutscene first.
I smell you, Ansem. Show yourself.
I have watched you fight. I know your strength. Your skill with darkness has grown. It has become more mature. And yet why? Why do you accept the darkness, but still refuse me? You know you and I are similar. We both follow where the darkness leads. Indeed, we are the same. So why? Does some part of your heart still have a fear of the dark?
That's not it. The truth is, I just can't stand your foul stench.
You are a fool. You should know my powers well by now.
Yeah, I know. Or did you forget? I used all the power you had to give, and Sora still beat me. I'm not at all impressed with your powers.
Very well. In that case, you shall sink into the abyss!
Alright guys, here it is, the final battle in Riku's story against Ansem. We can do this, you guys. And I like that line that Riku said of why he still refuses Ansem. He was like, I can't stand your foul stench. In the original Game Boy Advance version, he says, you just really stink. Which I find that hilarious. I wish they kept that. Oh well. And there was something else I was going to say. Oh yeah. Hope this isn't that hard to dodge. Oh, we could card break that. In the original Game Boy game, I could never beat Ansem. I always had my cousin do it for me. So yeah, that's perfect. I always had my cousin beat him for me.
Open your heart.
I don't know why I couldn't ever beat him. I don't know why. I mean, it's probably because it was all 2D and stuff, so it was like hard. But yeah. And here he's so much easier because of the 3D layout. Or not. I was going to do... Oh, wow. We're actually doing pretty good here, you guys. Okay, let's...
The final darkness is now.
Fuck! What the hell? I was not expecting that. And look, we died differently than how it normally is. I don't know. Maybe that's how it normally is. I don't know. It's been a while since we had to continue. Luxeus. Damn it. Back it is. We almost had him. It's just I should have had a zero card ready. But I didn't. Oh, well. Oh, let's get this one, too. All right, let's try this again. Gosh damn it. Stupid hiccups. The things I kind of hate about Freezes is you always, like, suck the flavoring out of the Freezy before you, like, get the ice. I knew I heard a Mickey card drop, but it must have disappeared. Oh, that wasn't going to do anything. Oh, that's okay. It was easy to dodge the first time. Oh, that is so cheap. But then we'll just do this. Yeah, we got the Mickey card this time. Alright, you. You asshole. Well, we'll get back. I should probably do the Oogie card.
Your Majesty.
Oh, well, this will work.
Come on.
Take this. Oh. Oogie. I should probably put the Lexus card as soon as I'm done with Oogie. Now he's... I think this is when he's gonna start putting I think this is when he starts with his slates. Okay, now the Luxeus card, if I can find it. Perfect. The good news is that doesn't count as an attack. What the heck was that about? What the heck was that about? Give us another Mickey card. It's always a good thing. Checkmate. Perfect. I like how we haven't entered dark mode yet. Damn you! Oh well, he's almost gone. Hopefully.
This one's mine.
Okay, he's on his last bar, and he hasn't done his cheap one yet. Do this. End it with dark aura.
You refuse the darkness.
We refuse the darkness, Ansem, by refusing you. And we did, you guys. Now prepare for a somewhat long cutscene and stuff. And then the credits, of course. And hey, we pick up the Mickey card. So I'm going to be quiet now.
Insolent.
Ansem!
This is the end.
This is hardly the end. Your darkness, I gave it all to you. My dark shadow lingers. Someday, I will return!
Sora. Kairi.
Gosh, Riku, I know you wanted to do this alone. But you don't mind getting a little help, do ya?
We gotta overcome in the darkness.
Riku. What happens next? Are you going home?
I can't go home. Not yet. It's still here. It's really faint, but I can sense him. So, I think his darkness may still have a hold on me.
Your darkness belongs to you, just the same way your light does. Up till now, I thought darkness was something that should never exist. Then, I spent time with you and changed my mind. The road you chose, I didn't know. light and dark, back to back? With you, I think they might meet in a way nobody's seen before. Wonder where that road leads. I'd like to see myself. Huh? I'd like to walk the road with ya.
Your Majesty, I'm really flattered. I don't know what to say.
Gosh, Riku! You know you don't have to call me that now. We're pals.
Fair enough, Mickey. What are you making me choose now?
Between the road to light and the road to darkness.
Neither suits me. I'm taking the middle road.
Do you mean the twilight road to nightfall?
No. It's the road to dawn.
with that, ladies and gentlemen, is the end with Road to Dawn, which means we completed Riku's story. And do we get another? Yes, we do. Proud player Riku. I forgot about that. That means we beat proud player. That means we beat proud mode as Riku. We beat Riku's story in proud mode. And look at this picture. It's pretty cool. And yes, okay, let's see. Game level, proud mode. D report covered. 100%. Adui. It's kind of hard not to get 100% as Riku for this. Card, collector rank. One who reigns over cards. Yes. And it's defeated. 2,619. Rapid breaks. 540 times. Card duels won. 74.39%. Not bad, not bad. And dark mode activated 110 times. Pretty good, I'd say. Clear time, 13 hours and 34 minutes. And with that, we'll save the game. Game clear data can be saved. If you load the save data, your game will start from the beginning of the last battle. Of course. Alright. Come on. Come on. Come on. Da-dun, 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 da-dun. And guys, with that concludes my Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts Re-Chain of Memories. I will start the Kingdom Hearts series again when Kingdom Hearts 2.5 comes out. As of right at this recording, it has not been announced at all. But who knows, maybe by the time this is released, it's already been announced. Who knows? Yep, and I'll do a Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. Because in here, like in Kingdom Hearts 1.5, like when you're on the main menu, it has extras and credits. If you watch the credits, it shows a little kind of a teaser to like, oh, hey, these are going to be in Kingdom Hearts 2.5, which is Kingdom Hearts 2, Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, and Kingdom Hearts Recoded. So, yes, we're back on the menu screen with Sora like that. So, thank you guys so much for watching. And starting next week, I'll start a new Let's Play. As of right now, I don't know what it's going to be. But, again, starting with that Let's Play, I'll go back to my weekly releases until Kingdom Hearts 2.5 comes out. Then I'll start doing daily again. I seem to do that with only Kingdom Hearts game and maybe longer games. I might do another RPG Let's Play, and then that'll be daily as well. But not now. All right. I'm going to go take a rest, and then I'm going to complete this game 100% it, along with Days and Kingdom Hearts 2, or Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, which are both already 100%ed. My recommendation for you, like, if you're new to old Kingdom Hearts series, it's kind of hard to say only play Kingdom Hearts 1 Final Mix and then play Chain of Memories and don't watch the Days cutscenes. It's kind of hard to say that because you're like, I want to watch the Day's cutscenes. But the thing is, like, most of the reveals that happen in Kingdom Hearts 2 are already given away to you on the Day's cutscenes. But yeah. But I'm guessing if you're going to pick up this game, you have some knowledge of Kingdom Hearts. You've already played most likely the second game before, so it's fine. But still, if you are new entirely, pick up this game still if you have a PlayStation 3. So yeah. Alright, and with that ends it. So until I see you guys next week in my new Let's Play of whatever right now, I might go back to Spyro, or I might start something new entirely. Until then, I will decide and think over it. And then when I decide and thought over it, I'll let you know. And you'll know because I'll release the video. And this is a long rambling. I probably could have done this during the credits, so maybe the credits were full of something. And maybe I could have kept the music under if I kept talking over it. Anyway, I'm done. Until then, I'll see you guys. And as always, take care. And thank you so much for watching.